Think your Power Query skills are pretty sharp? Well, put your skills to the test with this week's Excel challenge. This challenge comes from Microsoft MVP Alan Murray, also known as Computergaga, on YouTube. Here is your challenge.
Hello and welcome to this Excel challenge. This challenge will test your Power Query skills. We have this Excel spreadsheet named Sales Report, and on here at the moment, just this one table called Products, and it contains some simple product information. We want to create a pivot table report on this spreadsheet, but first of all, we need to get some data from an external Excel workbook. This is the other workbook. It's named Sales Data, and as you can see at the bottom, it has five different worksheets and also four different tables across it. The only tables we are interested in are those on the North, South, and East worksheets. And each of those tables follow a consistent naming approach. So that is something you can use to complete the challenge. This is what the completed workbook will look like. We have the three sales tables from the other workbook stacked into one table. And within this table, we have pulled across using Power Query the product and the category columns from that product table. So they're now all in this one table to create our pivot tables from. We have also created a conditional column to calculate the order size. And we've split the orders based on the volume of sales into 0 to 50, 50 to 100, 100 to 200, and 200 plus. You can also see we have a region column pulled from the table name of the data source. With that table created, we then created our two pivot tables. Feel free to be creative and explore your own way here, but your challenge is to create these two. We have a pivot table showing the sales of products and their category, and another pivot table showing the sales of those products again, but this time across the months of our data. It also has a filter for the region, so we're currently looking at only the South data. So there's quite a lot in this challenge, and I expect you're going to do some aspects a little bit different to what I have done. Testing yourself and working with challenges like this is a great way to learn and develop your Excel skills.
So, how will you tackle this challenge? Click the link in the description and download the dataset to get started. Share your progress or ideas in the comments section below. Or even better, join the GoSkills Slack channel and chat with other Excel pros about your approach. We'll be releasing the solution video next week, so make sure to set a reminder for the release so you can get the full step-by-step rundown on how Alan Murray solves this challenge. Good luck.